Hi all, Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at a Chinese solar panel from the famous company Dokio. This solar panel is 100 watt. It comes with a controller and all the necessary cords. This video is a continuation of the series of videos, traveling with a laptop. I will leave a link to the series of videos in the description. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos. Special thanks to your likes and reposts. The Dokio company produces solar panels with a power of 80, 100, 150, 200 and 300 watt. I measured the consumption of my laptop, it is about 30 watt. Since there will be power losses due to the fact that there will be a 12 to 220 volt converter and a controller, it is better to take a large supply of solar panels. I got a 100 watt solar panel and I think it will power the laptop even when it's a little cloudy. This is what the panel looks like when folded. As you can see, it is quite narrow, about a centimeter and a half thick. It has handles that you can use to carry this panel, but there are no straps with which you can carry this panel on your shoulder. This pocket contains the controller and the necessary cords. The solar panel kit includes such a controller and instructions for it. It's in English. This cord is used to connect the solar panel. This cord is for connecting the controller to the battery. This is an output cord with a set of adapters. And there is also this little cord, to which we can connect our 12-volt power supply system. Although this solar panel is portable, it is not always convenient to carry it over long distances. If you do not need to charge your laptop, but only need to recharge your phone, then you only need to have a lower power solar panel. Here is an example of a solar panel that can only charge a phone. Its power is 21 watt, the real current that this solar panel produces is about 1 amp. I will show this a little later. It will take about 2 to 3 hours to charge the phone. This is what this solar panel looks like when unfolded. There are two USB connectors here. As you can see, the LED lights up red. This means that there is voltage in the battery. This panel comes with a micro USB cable. If your phone has a Type-C connector, then you need to use your own cord. And two of these carbines are included. This solar panel is convenient to take on long hikes and to the mountains. You can put it in your backpack and it doesn't take up much space. At rest stops you can recharge your phone. I left the link where I ordered this panel in the description. In order for the voltage at the controller output to be constant, and not only when there is sun, you need to connect a battery. When the sun is bright, the solar panel charges both the battery and supplies current to the load. When there is no sun, the load is powered by the battery. It is recommended to use special batteries for the solar panel. I will use a gel battery. He is not afraid of a large discharge, and treats the charge-discharge mode well. Since the voltage on the solar panel is constantly floating, the battery is charged in this mode. Also, gel batteries charge well even at low currents. This battery is traction. In cars, starting batteries are used, which operate in this mode. A large current is used to start the starter, and then this battery is charged for a long time. If it works with solar panels, in practice its resource lasts for 2 to 3 years. Gel batteries can last 5 to 10 years. Let's connect this solar panel. I installed it on a stand that I designed myself. This is what she looks like. A little later I will make a video about this stand. When folded, it fits into a fishing rod case. Here I connected the panel. Here is a hole where you can pass the wire behind the panel. We go around. And here is our system. As you can see, the lights are on. These are 220 watt bulbs from the car. The panel produces 40 watt, at least. This is enough to power my laptop. How exactly it will work with a laptop, I will show this in the following videos. Please note that the battery must be used. Here in bright sunshine, if I disconnect the battery, You see, the voltage immediately rises and the lights begin to blink. That is, charging the battery works as a stabilizer. Let's see how the controller is connected. A solar panel is connected to this connector. Here is the wire to the panel. The battery is connected to this connector. It is recommended to install a fuse in the battery power supply. Fuses that are used for installing electrical wiring in cars are suitable here. And we have a load connected to the last connector. I'm using these connectors now. And 220-watt, 12-volt car lamps are connected. There are also two USB connectors at the end of the controller. I'll need both of them. One connector is for charging the phone, and the second is for powering the mobile internet amplifier, which I discussed in previous videos. You will find the link in the description. Let's see what the controller shows us. The sun is shown at the top left. This shows that the system is powered by solar panels. There is a battery in the middle, and it shows the state of its charge. As you can see, it is about two-thirds charged and continues to charge. The arrow on the left from the battery is where the solar panel current flows. The arrow on the right indicates that a load is connected. Below is the digital value. PV indicates that this voltage is coming from the solar panel. If BAT is the battery voltage, and if load is the voltage at the controller output. And on the left it shows V, this is voltage, A, current. It can also show the temperature. And also here timers are configured, and then the duration in hours H is shown. This controller is controlled by two buttons. With this button you can turn the load on and off. The fact that the load is disabled or enabled is displayed here. And with this button you can scroll through the menu in a ring. If you hold it for more than 3 seconds, then we enter the submenu. It also has its own meanings. This controller has quite a lot of settings. Two timers can be configured. The controller protection is also configured. The voltage level from the battery at which the load is turned off. If we consider all these settings, then we need to devote an entire video to this. If you need such a video, then write in the comments. Please note that the controller must be in the shadow. The back wall of the microcontroller gets very hot, so you need to create conditions for cooling it. There is no need to disassemble the controller. Unless you change the thermal paste on the heating elements of the electrical circuit. The battery should also be placed in the shade to prevent it from overheating. And as a result, my entire system is in the shadow of the solar panel. While I'm recording a video, my battery is fully charged. And the voltage from the solar battery goes directly to the load. But due to the connected battery, the load stabilizes. And, as you can see, the lights do not blink. When the battery was discharged, the solar panel provided energy to both charge the battery and my load. The combined current to the battery and load was about 5 amps. And the load power was about 60 watt. Now the battery is turned off, and all the energy from the solar panel goes to the load. Since this is a PWM controller, excess energy is simply cut off. This controller uses solar panel energy inefficiently. To use solar panel energy more efficiently, MPPT controllers are used. I will also talk about it in the next video. This controller can be used for this battery, but it will be more difficult to connect. Since there are no wires prepared for this, everything will be connected via connectors. When the energy of the solar battery is not enough to power the load, the controller will connect the load directly to the battery, and we can continue to use it. So I simulated a situation where there is no sun. More precisely, I turned off the solar battery. As you can see, the controller shows that there is no current from the battery. But, nevertheless, our light bulbs burn with the same intensity. That is, our light bulbs are powered directly from the battery. I will have a laptop as a load, and possibly lighting. Now I have two light bulbs connected with a total power of 40 watt. But to connect a laptop, I need a 12 to 220 volt converter. And the power supply from the laptop is already connected to it. I said in previous videos that I would try to connect the laptop from a 12 to 18 volt converter. But this converter has not been tested, so I don't recommend it. I will use this converter. The output of this controller is 10 amperes, that is, its output power is 10 amps. Multiplied by 12 volts, 120 watts. This converter is 300 watt. If we need to connect a load of more than 120 watts through it, then it must be connected not through the controller, but directly to the battery. It must be taken into account that under heavy load the battery will discharge quickly. And the process of this discharge must be controlled manually. Let's test the USB output of this controller. Here I connected via a USB load tester. Now I connected a gentle load. In short, I don't know. As you can see, 4.3 volts and 0.85 amps. We can connect a more powerful load, and it shows 3.8 volts and 1.48 amps. That is, at least 1.5 amperes, this controller produces. Let's see how much USB output a 21 watt panel provides. So I connected it. Here comes the cord, and here is our load. In gentle mode, it provides 4.57 volts and 900 milliamps, or 0.9 amps to the load. If I connect a more powerful load of 1.5 amperes, the voltage drops. As you can see, the red LED is on, but the voltmeter turns off. And this happens if the voltage on the voltmeter is significantly lower than 4 volts. At this current, the solar panel voltage drops significantly. And it is recommended to use it for currents of about 1 amp. The topic of obtaining solar energy is quite extensive. And I plan to record more videos on this topic. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss them. If you have any questions about these panels, write them in the comments. I would be grateful if you share your experience in using solar panels. Share the video with those for whom the topic of taming solar energy is relevant. Subscribe to the channel, like and see you in new and old videos.